Hey, hello friends, this is Deupal. Welcome back to my channel. So already you have done almost 21 program using while loop and for loop. So I hope you are pretty much confident. Just try to search in Google and find out some problems and try to do yourself. And if you think like if you unable to create the logic or provide the solutions, just make a comments. I'll provide the solutions with proper explanations. So let's start our today's topic. So it's a how to check whether a number is perfect or not. So first of all, you need to understand what is the definitions of perfect number. So if all the divisors of that numbers summations is equals to that numbers, then we call that number is a perfect number. 6 is a perfect number. Why? Because 6 is divided by 6 divisors, means divided by 1, 2, comma 3. Any others numbers, from others number we can divide 6? No, it will not divide. Okay, so with 3 numbers, I mean 1, 2, 3, so 6 will be divisible. So then we have to sum the divisors. So that is means 1, 2 plus 3. So that is nothing but a 6. So we'll check the summations of the divisors is equals to that original or not. If that, then we can say, okay, this is a perfect number. So fine, you are with the how to find out the calculations of a perfect number. Let's write the logic. Okay, so we are actually taking the number, let's say 6, and what I need to do? Yes, I need to do using one simple for loop. Okay, so in for loop, what I'll start, if any number they will give up to, I'll iterate up to that number, right? So integer I equals to 1. So I have to start from 1. Already we know any numbers always, what? Any numbers is always divided by 1, right? So if you not put 1, then you can also put 2, but you have to add it by default. Make sure. So I less than equals to that number, up to that number, right? Then I plus plus, we are incrementing one number, right? Then what I need to do, and here one things I want to let you know, if I do less than equals to number, will my program or logic will be perfect? No, because any numbers will divisible by 6, because we are trying to find out that number itself. So any number will divisible by that number itself. So if I will add this one, so normally by default that number should be greater than that perfect definitions, because 1 and this number will be always added. So here we have to calculate less than that number, so I'll use that less than instead of equals. Got it? So hope, I mean, you can think like this and you have to debug like this. Now what I'll check, I'll check simply whether this number is divided by I, right? So I will increment one by one. If this, then what I'll do, then simply I will do sum is equals to sum plus I, right? This sum I have to take as 0. Let's say I have taken as a 0. Then in lastly, I have to check what I have to check. If my sum is equals to original number of not, if that, then what I'll print perfect, else print not perfect. So what I missed here? Yes, I something missed here. So actually I forget to put here equals to 0, because in order to say any numbers is divisible by any number, so you have to check whether you are getting remainder 0 or not. Then that time we can say it's a divisible. Okay, so now let's copy this program and run in my IDE. Okay, so it's coming that way. I have taken integer, it's a sum. Now this part gone, and now I have to do system.out.println, and this is a perfect number, and this is not perfect, right? So now control plus F. So now what I did almost, now let's run. It's a perfect number. Let's check with a 7. It's a not perfect, right? So like this way you can actually write the program. And one thing, if the question will be different, you have to find out the divisors of the numbers, then what you will do? Yes, simply you have to omit this one, okay, and you have to do that system.out.println. You have to print the I. If you do this one and you don't need this sum variable, so then easily you can find out the divisor. So it's a saying, yes, it's a divisor is only 7. So now you have to give this one. Okay, so you can see 1 and 7. If you give 6, so definitely actual divisor is all those numbers. Okay, so just make a note. And one thing, do you think my earlier program, let me copy this one and put it in this here so that I can show you in different way. So do you think my earlier program will execute with perfect time complexity? Just think it. No. Why? Because we are checking actually less than number. So we know any number we are actually providing. Okay, any number we are actually providing. So that number actually it will be divisible up to half of this number. If I talking about 6, so it will maximum it will divisible by 3. By default it will divisible by that number itself, but that will not consider in case of perfect number, right? So maximum it will divisible up to by half of this number. So you don't need to iterate this loop again and again. So how many times we are actually iterating that loop, let me show you. So in this scenarios, that loop, how many times is iterating? So let's count plus plus. Okay, so you can understand like how to write that efficient programs. Okay, so in this case, these programs will actually iterating 6 times, because it is starting from 1 and up to it's a 6 times. If you give the large number 100, then it will definitely it would be a n 99 minus 1. So it would be like this, right? So now what I'll do, so I can actually think like this, this is a n by 2. If I do this one, okay, if I do this one, and I have to give this less than equal, because I have to check up to 3, right? So that is less than equals. So now if you check, this is what is the output, output also perfect, and my iterations reduced up to n by 2. Yes, not my iterations will go up to n. So that is called actually complexity. So earlier my program complexity was n. So now my program complexity reduced up to n by 2. That is called actually efficient programs. And you have to think like this. I mean, when you will get more matured and when you will have all the confidence, so that time you have to think small part, like how can reduce the time complexity, because less time complexity means your program will be faster and your application's performance will be increased. Hope you understand this logic. Still, if you have any doubt, just let me know in the comment sections, and at least I'll expect some feedback, like how whether this particular series making you confidence or increasing your knowledge or not. Okay, so hope I'll see you in my next tutorial. Thanks for the watching my video. Bye.